We're coming to you from the lawn of City Hall in Los Angeles, where hundreds of protesters have gathered since October 1st to occupy Los Angeles.
In unity with Occupy Wall Street.
As you can see, we have signs, 9/11, truth ends wars. I want you to end the Fed. Justice, not parties, and so much more. We're here in front of City Hall, Occupy LA. What exactly is that for people that don't know?
Occupy LA, to my understanding, and I'm not one of the leaders, and there are no leaders, but Occupy LA is in solidarity with the Occupy Wall Street movement that's happening right now with our brothers and sisters in New York. And the General Assembly here is working on, you know, basically what this movement is about. And we're definitely, I mean, I think the general feeling is that we're all in solidarity with New York, but we have, you know, our own issues as well that every individual here brings to the table. So I think that for me, overall, the disease in this country is that money rules politics. And I think I'm going to do what I can to, you know, put my voice into this and say, let's make our, if it was going to come down to one single demand for me, it would be, let's work really hard to get money out of politics. And I think if we can get money out of politics, if we can get people back into politics, you know, involved in their government, I think that the social issues would solve themselves. I think that we would just have a better, more self-sufficient country. And I think that message jives with conservatives, liberals, people of all types want to be self-sufficient, and they want money out of politics.
What do you have to say about what happened in New York with Occupy Wall Street and the cops going in and arresting people and pepper spraying them, etc.?
It's not right, man. And that goes to show to people that we're not lying when we say the things we say. Because there's people that hear what we're saying, and they don't really understand. And they get confused and they say, oh, you guys are bullshit and you guys are full of crap. That's not good, man. We're just trying to help out our fellow human beings.
Perfect. How long are you staying here on the streets?
Till it's over, man. Till we get what we're here for.
Well, first of all, I would agree that terminology versus protest would be movement, because it's about creating a forum for people to be able to dialogue, to have their voices heard. And the protest in the beginning, because there's frustration and anger that just needs to be released in a physical way. But then it's also about educating and information dissemination or dispersion. And then also having a place to be able to talk about all of these issues that are so important to people, and then figuring out what that boils down to, which of course has to do with economic inequality.
That's what we're pissed off about.
Yes.
Or is there other things?
Well, I think for me, and of course we're only in day 3 of inception for LA's chapter, but for me it's about economic inequality, and then it also becomes a conversation about community and humanity.
And I guess you get closer to your community by being here with these other hundreds of people that have the same goal as you.
I have not in my lifetime before now, except for in childhood in Indiana, seen a community come together and be open and not be so disconnected. We don't know our neighbors anymore. And here it's become a safe place where you are open to want to talk to your neighbor. You want to hear what their viewpoints are. And it's become a village again. And I think that's part of what the new doctrine is that we're looking for to explore.
It's a small village on the lawn of the Los Angeles City Hall.
Yeah, the lawn, and at night on the sidewalks.
Okay. So they actually kick you off the lawn at a specific hour?
The state law is that the parks are closed at 10:30 p.m. So we are no longer allowed to be in the parks or on the grass at that point. They've understood that we've been following the law. So no one's policing us in order to allow this to be okay, because we respect that. But there was an ordinance passed for homeless, basically, to be able to sleep on the sidewalks between 9 p.m. and 6 a.m. And so that was what has allowed us to be able to then shift to the sidewalks. But then at 6 a.m. we have to go back to the lawn in order to not impede traffic.
And are you in charge of this donation?
Yeah, the thing that we're determining here, what we're building here, is community. So everyone volunteers and chips in at their passion and at their skill level and their availability. But because I'm a film producer, my forte is organizing. So we all contribute, we all take care, we all manage, and just a part of that.
Do we know of a website or anything where we can find out more info?
We are located at OccupyLosAngeles.org. And we've been so busy with the organizing and the building of the first 3 days of events that it's been slow to update, but it will definitely get up to speed.
That is a wrap of day one coverage of Occupy LA's movement right here on the lawn of City Hall. It's day three for them, of day one for us, as our continuing coverage right here in Los Angeles, as Occupy LA moves forward. This is Jeremy Meyer reporting from City Hall for PSI Los Angeles.